There's been a lot of money chat this week. We learned we're borrowing more than ever before, but it also turns out we're stashing cash.
It's cash worth hundreds of millions of dollars, and it seems we're all hoarding it. So where is it?
As the old saying goes, money makes the world go round. But the way that looks has changed.
From plastic, fantastic, to Google Pay, to cryptocurrency, Dogecoin, what even is that? You might think cold hard cash is near extinct.
Turns out though, while you might not see it, it's there. We've been stashing it. There's a $600 million surge in Kiwi cash doing the rounds. But at the same time, transactions are down.
Really? In people's couches?
Yeah.
Must be.
Huh. It would make sense. Like, you want to take some precautions, but
I reckon it's probably because, like, a lot of people would be scared of economical collapse.
So is a stash of cash an old-fashioned solution to a modern problem?
And here to tell us more is Hannah McQueen, founder of Enable Me Financial Services. Thanks for joining us, Hannah. Tell us, what are we doing with all that cash?
Well, I think in financial or times of financial uncertainty, people tend to hoard a little bit of cash back. It's not always logical, much like hoarding toilet paper, but we find if we go back to the Y2K, the GFC, the COVID pandemic, people are nervous about money. And when you're nervous, you want to have more that you can touch and feel. And there are some people who are nervous about the bank's stability, whether that's founded or not, that's resulting in them wanting to have more cash accessible to them.
So is cash stashing a good plan? Should we all put some away in the undie drawer?
Well, it's not a wealth creation strategy. It's not even a debt reduction strategy. But I guess if you had it in the bank, it's not fetching or earning you too much. So the opportunity cost of keeping it under the mattress or in the undie drawer or putting it in the bank is quite low. I think what the cash gives a lot of people is it just allows them to be comfortable in a disaster. And I think people are really prevalent to disasters. So, you know, we've had these tsunami warnings, we've had the Christchurch earthquakes. Even if you've got money in the bank, and even if the banking system is super stable, you can't necessarily access that on a whim, especially if power's down or some of these other natural disasters have struck. That's one of the reasons why people are keeping some of the cash back.
Hannah, I'm told you advise clients to work with cash to save. With interest rates so low, why not just bank it?
Well, the reason why we use cash with some of our clients is more to get a behavioural reset, so to try and influence their psychology of spending. Because the thing with cash is that you are conscious before you spend when you use cash, because you're getting access to it, you're parting with it, and you feel it. And for a lot of people who do a lot of frittering, that can be a really effective way just to circuit break their behaviour. And the most common area that we would encourage that for would be in food purchases.
So, Hannah, is what you're saying perhaps that it's just too easy to spend on the plastic and that if we spend with cash that we might actually end up saving more?
Yes, absolutely. So there's lots of studies from many universities that evidence you become more disconnected from your spending when you're using a tap and go or even a credit card, right? The pain of payment, i.e. using cash, and the consciousness of that deters some people from spending, or at the very least reduces their unconscious spending.
That's really interesting. Thank you so much, Hannah.
Thank you for having me.
ASB and 7 Sharp, keeping you one step ahead.
It's fascinating, but not surprising, I guess, that if you use physical cash, you're likely to spend less because you're seeing it there. With the plastic, and now it's even easier because they're going to drop those bank charges too, yeah. It's going to be even easier to spend on the plastic.
Yeah, although some places now, of course, you can't use cash. I was out the other day and I went to pay for a loaf of bread and they said, oh, no, we don't take cash.
No.
This is a cashless cafe.
Wow.
And so luckily I had my card with me, but, yeah, not everybody... Because it's a hassle. You've got to take it to the bank, you've got to get change, you've got to get your float going. It can be quite difficult. Most people don't use cash anymore.
I know. I always carry it, but I very seldom use it. But I kind of like to have it as a backstop. I'm a bit old-fashioned, and I sort of think, well, what if my card declined, or what if something... I like to know that there's something there that I can pay for it.
I tell you the greatest feeling is every now and then when you go into a jacket pocket and find $5. It's like, yes, I forgot about that. That's
and the kids are watching, and they're going to go through your jacket pockets now.
Good point.